Because Melodyne can identify the individual notes in each recording, it can recognize the key, scale, and tuning, and display them. These are all things you can then edit.
Keys, scales, tuning, these are all important musical parameters that should on no account be ignored or ironed out. For this reason, Melodyne's approach to them is very sensitive and comprehensive. You can go into this subject as much or as little as you like.
Click below left to open the individual panes of the scale editor. The first column determines the key. The distances between notes here are, as a rule, equal in each case, 100 cents, but depending upon the key, certain notes are considered during editing, others skipped. You can also load exotic and experimental scales with all kinds of temperaments or tuning of individual degrees. This makes editing easy even when the music employs irregular scales. The background shading imitating a piano keyboard makes less sense, however, in such cases. Switch to something more appropriate to your actual material. Now open the next pane. Here you can create your own scales. Or, in the case of exotic instruments, let Melodyne detect the scale and tuning automatically by analyzing the audio material.
The scale editor has a wealth of functions, all detailed in the manual. Here are a few examples of its day-to-day use.
Suppose you change the key, say, from F major to F minor. Initially, nothing changes, but your subsequent editing will be affected, because when you move notes now, they snap to degrees within the new key. The ruler serves as a guide. You can only move notes to the light degrees, not to the dark ones. As a further orientation aid, you can switch the background from a piano-style layout to one that reflects the key. The rule now is that the white notes belong to the scale, the black notes don't. You see then that these notes need to go down one. In this case, it's obvious. This was A natural, the major third. But we need now the minor third, the A flat. Obviously, you can move notes to other pitches too, but they will snap within the selected scale, in this case, F minor.
You can also make notes move immediately to new positions as soon as you change the scale.
To do this, check the option Notes Reflect Scale Changes. Then change the scale, for instance, using the Open Scale menu. The notes will then migrate where necessary to the nearest available destination in the new scale. Notes common to both scales, of course, remain in place. The rest move to the nearest degree of the new scale. Let's stick with this Turkey scale. Its particular charm lies in the irregular intervals between degrees of the scale. Here, I have tuned all notes to equal temperament, 0 cent deviation, in other words. This is the tonic. The note below lies on a degree tuned slightly sharp. I have no desire to retune each note manually when editing, so I activate the pitch lines grid. The notes then snap to lines corresponding to the notes of the scale, respecting fully any irregularities in the intervals between them. Now I'll take the vocals, showing the guitar as a reference. Let's listen.
Beyond my words, there are moments.
They don't really gel because the original guitar accompaniment has changed. So I select all the notes and double-click on the pitch tool to make them snap to the pitch lines. So they are now using the same scale as the guitar and exhibit the same deviations from equal temperament of the various scale degrees. That's better already. Now you can adjust the melody as you think fit. The pitch lines show the available intervals. And of course, you can override the grid at any time in the interests of expression simply by holding down the Alt key. And also use the other pitch tools to enhance notes.
Beyond my words, there are moments of white. Erase all thought. Erase all thoughts and clear my mind.
Another example, dynamic tuning. Orchestral musicians play notes slightly flat or sharp, depending on their role within the chord. With Melodyne, you can do the same.
Here are four string parts played with a sampler. That doesn't sound bad. But unlike real string players, the sampler sticks to equal temperament. Look closely. The pitch deviation of every note is 0 cents. To hear the same thing with just intonation, select all notes. The rest can be done with one mouse click. Now the notes have moved. This one is 5 cents higher now. Elsewhere, the same note is even 7 cents higher. These are not random deviations, however, but determined by the musical context. It's because the note appears here in a different harmonic context from here that its intonation is different. Melodyne does all the hard math in the background, so all you have to worry about is how it sounds. The tone is now more vibrant and mellow, and it will blend perfectly with any string parts played by real musicians that you might wish to add later.
New application, stretched tuning. On some instruments, the lower strings are tuned slightly flat and the treble strings slightly sharp. In fact, a grand piano is always tuned like this. Now, when editing such an instrument, you don't want to mess this up.
Here we have a recording of a real grand piano. Look at the notes individually. This A is tuned exactly to concert pitch, zero deviation. An octave lower, the deviation is 2 cents, and the further down you go, the greater the deviation. You might ordinarily suppose that the lower notes were flat and should be corrected. In fact, with a piano recording, it's the other way around. The actual pitches are right, it's the grid that needs educating. So find the stretch tuning option and select default stretching. Exit with OK and the grid will adjust automatically. The notes initially will not be affected. But now look again. The pitch deviation of all notes is now shown as 0 cents, so you can edit overdubs normally using the grid and they will be perfectly in tune with the piano.
And why not get adventurous? Invent your own pitch system with, say, 30 notes per octave. It's all possible.
Or scrutinize exotic recordings. Just ask Melodyne how the instrument was tuned for the recording. You'll get two results. F major here is the closest tonality in equal temperament. But the scale shown here is more precise. You see the exact deviation from equal temperament of each degree of the scale. You can now record overdubs based on the detected scale and tune them to it. Alternatively, use the scale detective. Here, you can set a threshold to determine which notes should be included in the analysis.